Hello students, in our previous video of the NMR spectroscopy, we have seen the basic concepts of the NMR. And I hope all of you have seen that video. And many of you have demanded for the detailed videos on the NMR. So I have decided to make a series of videos on the NMR, and this particular video is on the physical portion, especially the portion that is necessary for the numericals point of view, right? And one thing I want to say here, that this video is also available in Hindi. So if you are Hindi viewer, you can watch that video. Okay. So starts NMR spectroscopy. What is it? We have seen in our previous video. And we know that in that video, we have said that when a charged particle spins on its own axis, this is its axis and it is spinning on this axis. So it will have a magnetic moment associated with it that we call mu. So this is the spinning and this is the direction of magnetic moment, and this magnetic moment is directly proportional to I. Here what is I? I is called the angular momentum quantum number of the nucleus, and it is a characteristic of the nucleus. It means it remains constant for a particular nucleus. For example, its value is half for the proton. It may be 0 for cysteine O, and its value may be 1 for the nitrogen, and for different nuclei its value may be half, 1, 3 by 2, 5 by 2 or 0. Okay, we have seen this topic in our previous video. Now mu is equal to gamma I. Here gamma is called the gyromagnetic ratio. Okay, now the nuclear spin is quantized. What is meant by quantized? It means when we put a nucleus with a nuclear spin I in a homogeneous magnetic field, in a uniform magnetic field, then it can take a certain definite orientations. It means it will take only some definite orientations. That is, if its nuclear spin is I, then it will orient itself in 2I plus 1 directions. If its spin is I, then the directions may be I minus 1, I minus 2, 0, minus I minus 2, minus I minus 1. Okay. For example, if we take a proton, 1H. For proton, we know that the value of I is half. Its value is half. So it can take two different orientations, that are plus half and minus half. But both will have same energy in the absence of magnetic field. They are degenerate. Similarly, for the 14N, its value of I is 1. So it can take three different orientations. 2I plus 1 value is 3. So it can take three different orientations, that are plus 1, 0 and minus 1. Right? So in this way, the nuclear spins are quantized. Okay, now the energy of the interaction between the nucleus that has the magnetic moment mu and the field in which we have put the nucleus, the field that is B naught, is given by E is equal to minus gamma H cross B naught Mi. Here Mi is the component of the nuclear spin. As we have stated earlier, that the nuclear spin can take certain orientations. It means it will have different components that are Mi. For example, for the proton, there are two components, plus half and minus half. So this will be the value of Mi for the proton, right? Now gamma's value, the value of gamma, gyromagnetic ratio, is given by Gn mu n. Here G is the nuclear G factor and mu n. It is called nuclear magneton, and nuclear magneton is given by E H cross upon 2MP. Here MP, what is it? It is the mass of the proton and it is the charge. Actually its value is fixed, that is 5.05 into 10 to power minus 27 joule per Tesla. Okay. So the value of E can also be written as E is equal to minus Gn mu n B naught Mi. Here we have put the value of gamma, so we get this value. From this we can calculate the energy, right? For example, if we take a bare proton, it means when a proton is not in the electronic environment and its nuclear spin is half. So in the absence of magnetic field, the two components that are plus half and minus half will have same energy. It means these will have degenerate states. These will have degenerate states. But when we put this proton in the magnetic field, these two states will split. It means they will have different energy. This plus half state will have the energy minus half Gn mu n B naught, and this minus half state will have the energy plus half Gn mu n B naught. Okay, it means in the presence of field, these two states get split. We can picturize it like this. This is the direction of magnetic field. It means when we have applied the magnetic field along the z direction, what happens? In the absence of magnetic field, when the magnetic field is zero, these two states will be degenerate. It means they will have same energy, and we write them both all along. It means plus minus half. But when we apply this magnetic field along the z direction, these two states get split. One state plus half, another minus half. Okay, so this will be minus half. Okay, so these are the difference between these two states will be del E is equal to Gn mu n B naught. So this state, the lower state, that will have the magnetic moment same spin as in the direction of the magnetic field, and this will have in the opposite direction of the magnetic field. Okay, and this is the difference of the energy between them. Now when we supply a radio frequency radiation, when we expose it into the radio frequency radiation, and that is applied perpendicular to this magnetic field, this is the direction of magnetic field, and when we apply the radio frequency beam in this direction, then what will happen? If its energy is equal to Gn mu n B naught, then there will be a flip of a spin from this state to this state. This spin is called the nuclear magnetic resonance. This is the condition of the resonance. Okay, till now we have seen the quantum mechanical treatment of the NMR. Now we see the classical phenomenon behind it. That is in the term of the Larmor precession. What is Larmor precession? We have seen here that we put the nucleus in a magnetic field that is along the z direction. When we apply a magnetic field along the z direction, this is the direction of the magnetic field, and this is the direction of the magnetic moment. This is the direction of the magnetic moment of the nucleus. So when we put this nucleus in this field, then what happens? This nuclear spin will rotate like this. It will form a torque, or it will form a cone, and it will rotate in this form along the z axis. Along this field it will move like this. It is just like the spinning of a top. As the top spins, similarly in similar pattern this nucleus will rotate along this z axis. This type of rotation of the nuclear spin along this z axis, along the applied field, is known as the Larmor precession. Okay, and the angular frequency of the Larmor precession, the frequency at which it is rotating, that frequency is known as the Larmor frequency. So these are the two components, mi is equal to plus half, and another mi is equal to minus half. So it will rotate like this, and that will rotate in the downward direction, and this is the energy difference between the two. And when the radio frequency will have the same frequency as that of the Larmor precession, then in that condition the resonance takes place. Okay, so the Larmor frequency is the angular frequency of the Larmor precession, and it is given by omega L is equal to gamma B naught. Now it is an angular frequency, so it is related to the linear frequency by omega L is equal to 2 pi nu L. Okay, so we can write nu L is equal to omega L upon 2 pi, and we know that gamma is equal to mu upon I h cross. When we put this value, then we get nu L is equal to gamma B naught upon 2 pi. So when the frequency of the radio frequency radiation is equal to this, then resonance condition takes place. So this is enough for this video. In our next video, we will see some more concepts behind the NMR. Thank you.